Good morning. Bobby, please read the problem, and Bo, please translate.
Flippin' physics.
A 0.280 kilogram object has a position described by the function x position is a function of time equals 5.00 times time cubed minus 8.00 times time squared minus 30.0 times time meters. What is the net power being delivered to the object at 2.00 seconds?
Mass equals 0.280 kilograms. Position is a function of time equals 5.00 times time cubed minus 8.00 times time squared minus 30.0 times time meters. And net power at 2.00 seconds equals question mark.
Thank you. Billy, is this problem asking for average or instantaneous power, and what equation should we use?
Well, it's asking for the power at a specific time rather than over a time period, so this is asking for instantaneous power. And the equation we should use is power equals the dot product of force and velocity. Although the question asks for net power, so actually it is the dot product of net force and velocity.
Correct, Billy. Therefore, we need equations for net force and velocity as functions of time in terms of unit vectors. Bobby, please figure that out.
We need the equations for net force and velocity as functions of time in terms of unit vectors. Okay, well, velocity equals the derivative of position with respect to time. In this case, velocity equals the derivative of our position function with respect to time. That equals 3 times 5, or 15 times time squared, minus 2 times 8, or 16 times time minus 30 meters per second. So we now have the velocity as a function of time. We need that in terms of unit vectors. Well, it's completely in the x direction, so just multiply it by unit vector I. Now we need net force as a function of time.
Remember, Newton's second law states that net force equals mass times acceleration, where both force and acceleration are vectors.
Thanks, Bo. So first, we find acceleration by taking the derivative with respect to time of the velocity equation we just found. So 30 times time minus 16 meters per second squared. Oh, and times unit vector I. And we can multiply that by the mass of 0.28 to get the net force equals 8.4 times time minus 4.48 all times unit vector I newtons.
Very nice. Now a short detour. Bo, is this object experiencing uniformly accelerated motion?
No. The acceleration changes as a function of time. It does not equal a number, so the acceleration is not constant.
Actually, we can tell that the object is not experiencing uniformly accelerated motion from the position equation because its largest exponent is more than 2.
Yeah. Acceleration is the second derivative of position with respect to time, so right. Because the largest exponent in the position equation is more than 2, it is not constant acceleration. Yeah.
Absolutely. Now, we know power equals the dot product of force and velocity. So our net power equals the dot product of net force and velocity, or the dot product of the two equations Bobby just solved for. Because both are in the I direction, it works out to be just the quantity 8.4 times time minus 4.48, all times the quantity 15 times time squared minus 16 times time minus 30. And the units are watts. If we were solving for power as a function of time, we would multiply those parenthetical expressions together. However, that is not what we are solving for. We are solving for the power at 2 seconds. So we substitute 2 seconds in for time in that equation, and we get, for the first parenthetical expression, 12.32, and for the second parenthetical expression, negative 2. Multiplied together, we get negative 24.64, And with 3 sig figs, that works out to be negative 24.6 watts.
Mr. P?
Yes, Billy?
Do we have to use unit vectors, or could we do this without unit vectors?
That is a fair question. You do not have to use unit vectors. Actually, Billy, that is a good idea. Let's solve for this without unit vectors as well. Could you please do that?
Certainly. Okay, net power equals the dot product of net force and velocity, which equals net force times velocity times the cosine of theta, the angle between those two vectors. And net force equals mass times acceleration. We can substitute in 0.28 for mass and 30 times time minus 16 for acceleration, and 15 times time squared minus 16 times time minus 30 for velocity. The net power at 2 seconds then is just that equation with 2 substituted in for time. And we get
negative 24.64 cosine theta, the same number we got before.
Yeah.
But what about the cosine of theta? What do we do with that?
That is a good question. What is the angle between the direction of the net force and the velocity at 2 seconds?
Well, we can figure out the direction of the velocity at 2 seconds. It is 15 times 2 squared minus 16 times 2 minus 30, or negative 2 meters per second. So the velocity is in the negative x direction at 2 seconds. But what about the direction of the net force?
Oh, from Newton's second law, we know that the direction of the net force acting on the object and the direction of the acceleration of the object are the same. So if we figure out the direction of the acceleration, we have the direction of the net force as well. The acceleration at 2 seconds equals 30 times 2 minus 16, or positive 44 meters per second squared. So the acceleration and net forces are in the positive x direction at 2 seconds.
Then the angle between the direction of the net force acting on the object and the velocity of the object is 180 degrees. The cosine of 180 degrees equals negative 1, so we get 24.6 watts with 3 sig figs.
But we got negative 24.6 watts using unit vectors.
Yeah.
We forgot to use the magnitudes of force and velocity in the power equation.
So
we need to take the magnitude of negative 24.64 in the power equation and multiply that by cosine theta.
Oh, yeah. So it is positive 24.64 times cosine of 180 degrees, which equals negative 24.6 watts with 3 sig figs. That makes sense.
But what does the net power delivered to the object at 2 seconds equals negative 24.6 watts even mean?
Yeah.
Again, that is a fair question. What does the net power delivered to the object at 2 seconds equals negative 24.6 watts even mean? Remember, watts are joules per second, which means because the net power delivered to the object is negative, the object is having 24.6 joules of energy removed from it every second. Now, we do not know anything about the individual forces acting on the object. However, we do know that the net force acting on the object is opposite in direction from the velocity of the object. Therefore, this object is slowing down, and kinetic energy is being removed from the object all at 2 seconds. And because we know net work equals change in kinetic energy, we know that at 2 seconds, the kinetic energy of the object is decreasing at a rate of 24.6 joules every second.
Okay, I get it. Because the net power delivered to the object is negative 24.6 joules per second, and net power equals the derivative of net work with respect to time, the kinetic energy of the object is decreasing by 24.6 joules per second. The net power being delivered to the object is currently decreasing the speed of the object.
Exactly. One possible example of what this could be is that the object is sliding on a surface where the coefficient of kinetic friction between the object and the surface is not constant, and instead the coefficient of kinetic friction changes as a function of position. For example, a wood surface which is not evenly sanded. That could cause the net force to be equal to the force of kinetic friction, which could change as a function of time, as described by the net force equation we derived in this problem.
That seems unlikely.
Yeah, maybe. But having the coefficient of kinetic friction change as a function of position makes the acceleration of the object non-uniform, which is always good to review.
Yeah,
yeah.
It is.
Sure.
Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.